Okay, so I'm gonna continue here because I think this is quite an, you know, interesting subject, you know. I think that, you know, when something is meant to be, it's just going to unfold in the direction that it will take you to wherever you need to be, you know. And the thing is that actually every single time I sort of has thought during these, I would say since like 2015 or something, that I've been thinking about that, okay, the Islam is not for me, you know, that it's something that is, it's just, you know, a fast or something, like people would say that to me, like, ah, okay, well, you're doing this, but you're not Muslim and these things. And I must say that every time it was sort of getting more and more, that every time I was thinking, okay, Islam is not for me, and I was trying something else, something happened that made me, the only thing I was like pushed towards Islam, you know. And also, as probably most Muslims know, the Quran itself is very powerful, you know, when you're listening to the recitation, you know. And I have had some situation where I have had to make really important decisions, you know, and really, you know, listening to myself for what is right and what is wrong. And in those situations, the Quran has just given me a lot of strength, actually, to go about and take these hard actions, you know, not hard actions, but hard decisions, you know. So it has been quite a good, you know, sort of journey. And then I have studied about Islam for quite a long time now, or at least for, you know, more than 6 months. And I have got like certifications on it as well. So that is a good thing. And I feel like every time I'm sort of adapting into the, you know, Islamic sort of practice, and I'm doing, you know, the prayers and just being mindful about it, things are just functioning in a very synchronizing formal way, you know. So I feel like probably I've been Muslim for quite a long time, but it's just that I haven't, you know, it hadn't been in my sort of full conscious mind, you know, that I have understood it myself. Sometimes, and I think this is quite usual for people who doesn't have any reference, you know, from their background, and they're coming into something, that it will take quite a long time to actually understand the meaning of it, you know, and understand the importance, you know. And because it needs to sort of process for you, and sort of, you know, you need to sort of understand the meanings behind certain things, and you also need to see how it fits into your life and so forth. But for me, you know, I have, when I've been in, for example, in Jordan and other places like in United Arab Emirates, I have found that, you know, it's home for me. I feel like very much like home. So when I've been going to these places, I have just experienced like, oh, okay, this is exactly what I've been thinking, there must be something like this, you know, because this is exactly like me, you know, as a person, you know. I find everything that I like is over there, you know, in those places. And it's, you know, one of the things is Islam, you know. So, yeah, so it just makes sense, you know. And I think that, you know, I don't know, because, you know, there are certain religions, you know, that people are drawn towards, and I have never had like any religion that I've been drawn towards. towards. As I said, Islam is the only thing. But it's funny that I sort of have read about so many religions, you know, and even, you know, when I've been in university, I mean, I have a sort of academic, formal, you know, analytical, formal way of thinking. So, I mean, I've been reading about so many religions and spiritual practices and traditions, but yet I've been living in, you know, for example, in spending so much time in Dubai and in Jordan and in these places and being exposed to Islam, but it hasn't got to me that that is what I should sort of, you know, learn about more and sort of try and understand. Even if my friends have, you know, I've been on iftars and yet I've been thinking about other religions, and yet I've been there and taking part in all of those things, but it hasn't got, you know, it haven't clicked that this is it, you know, this is what I should also be doing. And even during Ramadan, you know, like, it's funny because you think that I would have thought that, oh, this is, I should be a Muslim, but that has not gotten to me. And I think that the thing is that when I've been in those places, I have been already, you know, I have been like a Muslim since I was like, since maybe 2014, but I haven't understood it, you know. So when I actually was more or less, you know, in like later on, I actually understood it, you know, but and especially when I sort of had a perspective of not being around in that form of environment, I just realized that I had become a Muslim in that environment because that was how I was going about and doing my form of everyday life and just the way I was thinking. And even my spiritual kind of journey and everything that I was sort of adapting, it was Islam, you know, but I didn't realize it, you know, even if I was surrounded by it, which is quite funny. But that's how it is, because it wasn't my intention, you know, because I didn't want to go into some, you know, structured form of religion. But Islam is like, I mean, when you're going into it, it's just, there is like, it's very hard to put any words on it except to say Islam, you know. That's like, that's all I would say about it, you know. So yeah, but I think that one important thing is actually to talk to other Muslims and also to talk to other people who have other religious beliefs and to sort of get your mind around different things, you know, because that would be very helpful for you to sort of, you know, get to the core of what you sort of can agree on in religious forms of terms. And I think that you already know what you're actually agreeing on, because for me, I already knew sort of how my perspective was, and then it was just that it didn't fit within any of these things that I was presented to until I came across Islam, and I was like, okay, well, that explains most things, you know. So I was like, that makes sense, you know, because this is already what I sort of thinking, but I don't find it in any of these other things. And I wouldn't say that, for example, I'm still doing yoga and I'm still enjoying it, and I think that you can still, you know, for example, you can still do yoga even if you're a Muslim, you know. So that's quite, you know, it works. But yeah, so what else should I say? I just want to share this because I think that quite a lot of people, and by the way, I am, let me see here, okay, I am, I'm just looking at the battery because it's almost going to pass out. But I am like over 25. I am almost 26. So I think that I have sort of, you know, I have taken my time before I have adapted to this. Yeah, it's like I'm just shaking on my phone because it's after 11 in the evening. Yeah, so I haven't rushed into anything. I think I have really given a lot of time to the things. And I think that can be an important thing if you know, considering learning about Islam and also to learn about other religions and just getting a different way of, you know, understanding the context and the reality, or, you know, how you can sort of put a finger on the reality. So, yeah, let me see if there is anything else I should add on to this. And also, I mean, things when you actually starting to practice, if you are going to convert, is that it's not going to be like, okay, now. Like, I would say, yes, in one way, it's going to be like a now experience, because if you start pray, it's something that, okay, you take it on, but you do not need to start off by doing every prayer, like, on timings, every single day. I mean, whatever you feel comfortable is what is important, and also what works for you. But also think about it that you are not here, you don't know how much time you have, you know, in front of you. So why waste time, you know? And that's one of the things that I was thinking about, like, okay, you know, it's important to use, since I'm already like having a clue of that this is what I'm gonna go for, like I am a Muslim. I thought that I don't have that much time to just reflect on whether or not I should be a Muslim. It's much better that I am just a Muslim, you know? Because I was like, before I even could say to myself that I was Muslim, I was like dreaming about that. You are a Muslim. This is what you stand for, you know? And like how the sort of religious kind of perspectives and stuff. So I was like sort of even trying to, I was saying to myself that I am not a Muslim, but then my, you know, subconscious was like, no, you are a Muslim, but you are not really accepting it, you know. So that's how it can be. So yeah, but as I said, because a lot of people also think that, oh, because you were a Christian before, you, that's why you came to Islam. No, I don't want to say that it's because of some other religion that I came to Islam. Like, every religion has their own perspective, and I don't think you really should be comparing too much. I mean, because for some people it does make sense, and I mean, then that is the truth for them. So it wasn't because of that, it was just because of my experience, you know, like how things, what I have sort of felt is the right thing for me, you know. And that is something that I cannot compare to anything else unless it actually makes sense. And that's how I came across this, you know. But I hope for anyone who sort of is, you know, just knowing but not really sure about things yet, I think that I hope this can make some, you know, give some perspectives, because I don't think anyone has gonna go the same path exactly like me, and I don't think anyone else sort of journey is exactly the same as anyone else. So I cannot say what's going to be on your path, but what I can say is that in case you are considering, or if you are interested, do some research and, you know, try and get hold on Quran, because that's quite, this is like one of the things that you can actually hold to, like in a physical sense. The Quran is something that is physical and you can actually read it, you can listen to it, and that sort of it sort of opens something in you if it's something that is meant for you to sort of resonate with. So try and see if that is something that's going to make an impact on you, and otherwise keep on searching for whatever you are meant to find. And yeah, I think I can end here because the camera is either way, you know, it's not, my camera is not enjoying these kind of long videos, but yeah, so anyway.